Hey, this is Hans from Dakota Angler and Outfitter. In this video, we are going to tie a tungsten quill jig, and we are going to use the synthetic tapered peacock quill from Hemingway, along with their peacock dubbing brushes. And this makes a really cool looking quill jig that is so simple and quick to tie. So let's tie one up here. We've got a tungsten bead on a jig hook, barbless jig hook. You can use any of the Hanak models and a matching tungsten bead. And we're going to start with some fine, this is 12-aught Vivus thread. And I want to use a light color, so I'm using a light yellow here because I want, you can either use that or a cream. I want the transparent quill to go over a light background. So in this case, that light background is going to be our light thread. So either a cream or a light yellow. We're going to tie in a tail. I've got some cocktailion fibers here in brown. You could use medium pardo or ginger pardo, whatever color you want. Want those to be about the length of the hook. Tie those down. Trim off your excess. Flatten my thread out just a tiny bit by spinning it. We'll go back here to the back. Fill in any little gaps. And now, what I've done is I've got this quill body and I've taken it off the adhesive backing. And there's a little dark line on the bottom. I want that line to be on the bottom as I tie it in. Meaning the light side is up, the dark line is down here on the bottom. Go ahead and tie that in, wrap our thread forward. If you want to build a little more taper here, you could use some thread wraps kind of going back part way and filling that in. It's up to you how you want your fly to look. Now we just have to take the quill, wrap that forward. You can lay them touching or slightly overlapping if you want a little more of a stand-up rib. Tie that off. Now these quills are long enough to tie a couple of different flies with. What I'd recommend is, since it's getting thicker, just save the remainder of this quill for a larger hook. You can use that on a larger pattern, like a bigger stonefly nymph or something like that. Put it back on the backing in your package. Now we can take our nice little fine peacock dubbing brush. And in this video, I'm using the olive colored, the yellow colored peacock quill. And I'm using the bronze peacock brush. So once I've tied that in, just make a couple of turns on a larger fly, one or two turns, you know, you get down to that size 16. I've tied these even on a 16, and you can still use these brushes because they're nice and fine, but what you want to do is just do one turn and then go ahead and trim out the excess brush. And now you can whip finish. If you wanted to put a hot spot in there, you could, with some switch to a bobbin that has some brighter thread or floss on it. I'm just going to do a whip finish, take off my excess thread. And there we got a quill jig that's really slender, super easy to tie. It's got that nice realistic segmentation from the transparent synthetic peacock quill from Hemingway. Very quick tie, fun to mess around with the different colors and come up with a color scheme that works best on your water. Thanks for watching.